playing is where you mimic the sound of two guitars playing at one time. And I've done a little bit of this already. So like if I were just to strum with like one guitar, I could do. So that's one guitar. Piedmont guitar is broken into bass notes and high notes. And so for me, I found myself in this really interesting spot thinking about Piedmont playing in the context of chamber music, which is something I hadn't really done before. And so this is a little medley of train numbers here, just to kind of show you how, they also mentioned the word folk settings, and a lot of folk songs are placed into their own type of folk settings by the tradition bearers that might play them. And so this one, I set this one as a series of train songs. I'm going to start out with one of the most famous ones from a woman from Carborough, North Carolina, named Elizabeth Cotton, who lived up here in D.C. many years. And then I'm going to go into Railroad Bill from a woman from Morganton, North Carolina, in the hills of North Carolina. And her song, Railroad Bill, it was Etta Baker was the one who performed that one. So we'll do a little bit of Etta Baker. And then I'll end out with the Cannonball, which is one that was done by a fellow in Burnsville, North Carolina, a fellow by the name of Leslie Riddle. Leslie Riddle traveled around. He never made many recordings except when he met Mike Seeger in the mid-60s. But he traveled around with a fellow by the name of Alvin Pleasant Carter, A.P. Carter. And during about 2 or 3 year period of time, he and A.P. would travel around to the mountain hollers finding songs for A.P.'s recording group, the Carter Family. And so the Cannonball was one of the ones that Leslie taught to A.P.'s sister-in-law, Maybelle Carter. I'll play a little bit for you just to end off the train. And so on this one, I'm going to try to not do too many embellishments to start out, but just to demonstrate the embellishments as I go, I'll get a little fancier. So just to show a little bit of that, but that's kind of my way of connecting to harpsichord music. But again, keep an eye out for the chamber music type quality. There won't be any singing on this one here. I'll start out with Freight Train, though, which is a beautiful one to sing, but for this performance, I'm just going to pick it. But I can't stop you if you start. Ain't that a Pete Seeger way of doing things?